assume is it used to that's the scene.
On the towel.
I understand right that some people don't speak Finnish, right? Okay, cool. I will just introduce myself. I'm Lauri Wuolio, and most of the time I play the instrument kupola, or handpan in English. And today I also brought my sampler that I hardly have ever used before, so everything here today is an accident. And I hope you enjoy the accident. Let's see. By the way, all the samples that I play from the Octatrack, they are from some decades ago. They used to have these vinyl records, and they had like test signals to calibrate the machines. So I've just like sampled all kinds of historic test signals, and yeah, they sound cool.
What you're going to hear about today is nothing short of a miracle.
1,000 cycles per second, sine wave test tone. United States government standard.
As long as we're getting a bit technical, I'd like to remind you that most women and children can perceive higher frequencies of sound than most men. This demonstration consists of a continuous sweep of audio frequencies from 50 cycles to past the limit of audio. First, 50 cycles to 500 cycles.
Thank you.
What if I don't want to? No, just a joke. I will play you just a small improvisation with the handpan.
Time for a short break, 10 minutes, was it 10 minutes, okay? Yes, yeah.
every third tries to,
yeah,
you know, a little bit more simple.
This is a beast. It's super complex. I've just had it a couple of weeks,
yeah.
So I know the basics, but every time I open it, it's just like, you know, it surprises me. Which is a good thing.
Why have you chosen this one? I've been
using Ableton Live on computer for, you know, a decade or something, so I know it inside out. And I'm really used to work with samples, so I wanted to have a really, really, you know, powerful sampler that I can make crazy stuff with. This that I did just today, it was like super basic. It was really basic stuff. And I actually even bit lost. I wasn't sure where I was at.
It's a mistake, right? It's not only a sampler, but also a synth, right?
It's not really, well, I mean, you can use it as a synth. Like, if you just like use a short sample of like sound wave, so you can just loop it like.
But can you modify it?
Yeah, of course. Yeah. You can modify it. You can use it as a mono synth, basically. And you have a drums, you can control other MIDI gear with it. You can use it as a looper.
It doesn't have an
oscillator. But of course, you can use it as a kind of wave tune or something. If you have an oscillator,
even just simple signs,
you
can pull it there.
Well, that's kind of what I did today, actually. I had like sampled these long test sequences, like, but then I used it in a like more melodic way.
It sounded already pretty cool after 2 weeks.
I used a similar kind of concept with the laptop before, so I kind of knew what to expect with the sounds, but then I just wish I had enough time to really learn this, because I've heard some really incredible stuff people do with this.
It's an amazing idea also. I love this concept of everything in one box. That's really amazing. When you add additional instrument, it's
Today the plan was to have one of the tracks in the language translator. So one of the tracks I was supposed to actually bring my hand pan with the mic in here. So I could have actually like sampled loops of that and then chopped it up
and
make really made it really crazy and of course just use some basic like reverb and but then I thought, but this is just a simple. So why make it too complicated? Sometimes simple things they can be nice too.
How much memory does it have?
Not much, I have to say. I think you have only 64 megabytes of RAM. But then you can stream samples from the CF card. But that's like 60 megabytes or something.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
For a start,
yeah, absolutely. If you want to use really long samples and make crazy stuff with that, but like really twist the samples, then you might have some like drops in audio, but usually like you still have 64 megabytes, and that's like 8 or 9 minutes.
And so you can plug in anything pretty much and then sample it live and use this.
Exactly.
Wow.
I have like 4 inputs. So I can have like 4 tracks just like sampling in here. And I can also sample internally. So if I come with a really nice pattern, I can just like resample it to 1 track and then continue building on top of that.
So is it kind of constantly recording as a loop machine?
I can trigger the looper. Yeah, it's possible. And then you can overdub, and then you can, you know, you can record that, and then you can chop that and make crazy stuff, modifications of that. And then you can resample that, and then you have another sample. You can keep on doing that, repeating forever. It's an amazing machine, I have to say. Like really powerful, super powerful, super reliable. And I didn't even touch this crossfader today. But you can like really easily make like all kinds of mappings like between the like different effects, or like I can use it like to twist the sample, like reverse it like this, and it still keeps on track. You can basically make, like automate this to anything, like map it to anything. And then I can do like super fast changes between like different kind of settings.
And what kind of music did you do in Ableton?
I do a lot of different kind of stuff. So I'm lately I've been composing quite a bit like movie for movies, film music, and for some radio plays and documentaries and stuff like that. But then I have this experimental side that all the time goes like, so sometimes it's like really hardcore stuff.
Yeah.
And then sometimes it's something else. Yeah. But I focus a lot of art on people.
Yeah, my friend had this pang drum.
Yeah,
just played it without. I think probably it's most of the idea that you have a groove box or a center plus plus hand drum.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm currently using this groove box for the guitar.
Mm. Yeah,
yeah, it's a lot of fun.
Yeah, it's exactly. Yeah, it's super fun when you can play.
Yeah.
Setting like all these curves.
carpeted steps with a weird wooden thing. And also chilling, listening. And then all these different rooms. The third floor is like pretty small. It's all rounded.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. last copies of our tape for sale today.